In exciting new research, a team from the Graphene Flagship has recently published work showing how it is possible to interface graphene with neuron cells while maintaining the integrity of these vital cells. This work, published in the journal ACS Nano, was an interdisciplinary collaboration between various universities with nanotechnologists, chemists, biophysicists, and neurobiologists, all playing an important role. The Graphene Flagship is a European initiative which promotes a collaborative approach to research with an aim of helping to translate graphene out of the academic laboratory through local industry and into society. Scientists have always found the human brain endlessly fascinating, and our understanding of the brain has increased to such a degree that by interfacing directly between the brain and the outside world, we can now harness and control some of its functions. For instance, by measuring the brain's electrical impulses, sensory functions can be recovered. This can be used to control robotic arms for amputee patients or any number of basic processes for paralyzed patients, from speech to movement of objects in the world around them. Whereas by interfering with these electrical impulses, motor disorders such as Parkinson's can start to be controlled. Scientists have made this possible by developing electrodes that can be placed deep within the brain. These electrodes connect directly to neurons and transmit their electrical signals away from the body, allowing their meaning to be decoded. The interface between neurons and electrodes has often been problematic. Not only do the electrodes need to be highly sensitive to electrical impulses, but they need to be stable in the body without altering the tissue they measure. Too often, the modern electrodes used for this interface, based on tungsten or silicon, suffer from partial or complete loss of signal over time. This is often caused by scar tissue formation from the electrode insertion and by its rigid nature, preventing the electrode from moving with the natural movements of the brain. Graphene has been shown to be a promising material to solve these problems. Its excellent conductivity, flexibility, biocompatibility, and stability within the body sparked the interest of researchers. The work published by these researchers is unique, both in the results they found, but also in the way they used graphene in their study. Previously, other groups had shown that it is possible to use treated graphene to interact with neurons. However, the signal-to-noise ratio from this interface was very low. By developing methods of working with untreated graphene, the researchers retained the electrical conductivity of the graphene, making it a significantly better electrode. They found that the untreated graphene electrodes interfaced well with the neurons. By studying the neurons with the electron microscopy and immunofluorescence, they found that they remained healthy, transmitting normal electric impulses, and importantly, no adverse glial reaction which leads to the damaging scar tissue was seen. This is therefore the first step towards using pristine graphene-based material as an electron for a neuro interface.